Hey guys, it's Maddi here. I am back with another video. My autopilot's on, so don't worry if I'm not touching the wheel the whole time, but I will be paying attention. You are currently in my Tesla. We're driving around Wilmington because I'm gonna be showing you guys the playlist of my life. So I did an interview series a few months ago with my athlete friends about the playlist of their lives, where we went through the songs that basically documented their entire life, and it was really, really fun. I worked with Michael Carter on the UNC football team and Mason Barnes, big wave surfer from Riceville Beach, so it was a really, really fun series, but I want to wrap it up and answer them myself, so let's get started. First question is, what song reminds me of my childhood and being with my family when I was younger? And I had to say Cherry Pie for this one by Warrant, and my dad was the lead singer of that band, so that song has followed me from then till now, and it's very iconic. I hear it all the time, but that one was a dead giveaway, and I'm gonna go ahead and put it on real quick. It's a slow build up. Fun fact about this song, I always asked what it was about and he was very reluctant to tell me, but now I know, obviously, based on the context clues and the innuendos, but it's a classic. Dad. It's weird thinking about your dad as like a teenager, like sleeping with girls and like being like a sex icon, I guess. It's weird, but props to you, Pop. So the next one, what song speaks to who you are or what you've been through? So I had to think about this one, but this is a song called So Am I by Ava Max. I love it because it kind of talks about like being kind of an outcast and a misfit, and growing up, I kind of always felt that way. I moved a lot, my friend groups changed, and things were really inconsistent. So I've like kind of used it as a way to stand out and be different. So let's listen to it. I feel like a misfit, and it's okay to be different. Why are you trying to be just like the neighborhood? I tried at those high notes. All right, so this next one is, what is your favorite summer or vacation song? This is a very basic answer, but honestly, I couldn't help myself. I had to say Levels by Avicii, RIP also, but that anytime Avicii comes on, I just feel like I'm sitting on a beach just like with like a margarita in hand at a, like a beach party. So let's go and put it on. Yep. No lyrics, just vibes. I love his other stuff too, but this one is just so iconic. Like, everyone's heard it. They might not know what it's called, but you know this song. So this one says, what song brings you back to your first year at UNC? It's definitely Black Beatles by Ray Shrimmerd, because that was when the Mannequin Challenge came out. I was just like getting into like frat party scene. I thought it was so cool, and it was just iconic. So let's do it. All right, we can do the Mannequin Challenge. Let's do it in the car. I won't do it, I'm just kidding.
Smoke in the air, binge drinking.
That's true. All right, so what song gets me through a hard time in your life? So, a song that came to mind initially for me was a song called Scared to Be Lonely with Martin Garrix and Dua Lipa. And I was going through a breakup, you know, we've all been there. And that song really just helped kind of put it into perspective. It was a messy breakup. That song is talking about like, okay, so do we want to be together? Why do we keep coming back? Is it because we like each other or because we're scared to be lonely? And I was like, damn, that's true. Like, okay, that's how it was. So it kind of validated my feelings and made me feel less crazy. A good workout song as well. When I was like at the gym trying to get my mind off of things, this one definitely came through for me, so. Yeah, just take a minute.
It was great from the very start. Now we're picking fights and slamming doors, magnifying all our flaws.
All right, beat drop.
Here we
go. Yeah. All right, we're back on the road. We got out of our feels. Now, what's a song that helps me get ready for a run or a workout? So, I have a whole entire playlist on my Spotify. I love a variety of like hip hop and rock, but I had to throw it back to some Foo Fighters, Monkey Wrench. That song is just psychotic. I love it.
Planning my revenge.
Upbeat and crazy song, so whenever that comes on, I'm just ready to like pump it on the treadmill or do what I gotta do. I saw them live and they were just as good live as they are in the car. So we're gonna switch up the vibe a little bit here. What is my go-to pre-game song? So there's so many I like, but I'm typically a hip-hop gal when it comes to going out and like feeling myself. So I went with No Limit by G-Eazy, ASAP, and Cardi B. This song comes on, I'm on the dance floor, like I'm there. It sounds great with the bass in this car or like on a nice speaker. To go really fast. I literally am like having to slam on my brakes right now. I'm pumped. I'm ready to go to the club. I'm ready to take a shot at the bar. If this comes on, it's over. It's over. Okay, I like this one. What's a song that's got me through the pandemic? So something I've discovered recently is a song by an artist called Brayland. I hope I'm saying that right. But it's called In the Woods, but Woods is spelled W-O-U-L-D-S, In the Woods, so it's a play on words a little bit. It'll all be worth it, knock on wood, baby. Tell me what you want, I would do it in a heartbeat. Put a ring on your hand, rock tight, baby. The next question, oh, okay, I love this one too. What is my guilty pleasure song? So I used to be a really big Justin Bieber fan. They call us believers. I was hardcore, like Twitter account. I messaged him every day. I thought I was gonna marry this man, literally. Aww. Hailey Bieber got him, that's all good, you know? We don't have any beef, but I used to be literally obsessed with him. So he'll always have a place in my heart. Like if I hear this, it like takes me back to like being awkward 13-year-old fangirling, but it's Stuck in the Moment by Justin Bieber. And he sounds like a child. I wish we had another time. I wish we had another place. Now Romeo and Juliet, bet they never felt the way we felt. Okay. I won't let that be you. So this next question is, what is a song that I could sing or rap all the lyrics to with no hesitation? I had no hesitation picking the song Bedrock with Young Money. That song reminds me of like sixth grade, but for some reason I know every single verse, and we don't have to listen to me rap all of them because that might be a little cringy, but we're just gonna play a little bit of it. She got that good, good. She Michael Jackson bad. I'm attracted to her for her attractive ass. And now we murderers because we kill time. I knock her lights out and she still shine. I hate to see her go, but I love to watch her leave. But I keep her running back and forth. Soccer team, cold as a winter's day, hot as a summer's eve. Young money thieves, steal your love and leave. I think that guy just gave me a thumbs up. And if he thinks my rapping's good, then I'll take it. So now, what is the best song of all time? Oh my God, how do I pick the best song of all time? But if I had to, I'd have to go with Queen. Queen, I mean, I just love them as a group in general, but Somebody to Love by them, it honestly speaks to my love life because will I find somebody to love? I don't know, hopefully. Find me somebody to gospel like influence in the song, like Aretha Franklin. Oh, so good. Who's born and I get out by dialing? Can't barely stand on my feet. Just can't get no relief. Lord, somebody, 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 somebody. You can just like feel his emotion. Like you're like, yes, like will I find somebody to love? Somebody, 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 somebody. Anybody find. That is it. That is all the songs I have. It was so fun to go through the playlist of my life for once. So I hope you guys enjoyed my playlist. I'll also have it on my Spotify, so you can feel free to check me out, Maddi Lane. It'll be called The Playlist of My Life. And I'll see you next time. Thank you.